Hi, I'm Jake, and I am... Whew, so glad you're here. I was just sitting in this room all alone, as Hannah usually makes me do, and I'm starting to feel like the loneliest place on the internet. .blogspot.com. Now, this blog by Boy Punk is kind of more of an artist statement, I guess. There's no blog posts or anything, so you can't interact with it. You can't leave comments or likes or any sign of activity. But it does seem lonely. And we're gonna look at some very lonely dongs. Things that you can do online now, guys. The reason the loneliest place on the internet.blogspot.com isn't necessarily lonely is because it is an unfeeling website. It may be isolated and cut off from any social contact, but that actually doesn't make it lonely. That just makes it alone. Now, Wikipedia defines loneliness as the discrepancy between one's necessary and achieved levels of interaction. So you could be in the middle of the woods with no one to talk to, but if you feel content, you're just alone, not lonely. And if you're experiencing the reverse at a party, surrounded by people you feel you cannot connect with, but want to connect with, you are lonely, but not alone. But how lonely are you specifically? Well, find out with this UCLA loneliness scale, because loneliness can be linked to a multitude of problems, including but not limited to high blood pressure, depression, and alcoholism. It has been researched for years. In 1978, the first version of the UCLA loneliness scale was created, but the one on this website is the revised and condensed version. Answer each of these 10 questions using a 4-point scale ranging from never to often to see just how lonely you are. Notice how each of these questions deals with how you feel about situations in which you are alone, as opposed to simply asking how often you are alone. So on this quiz, I personally scored a 27, and if we look over at the key here, it says that I have moderate loneliness. And now, that being said, being alone is often a cause of loneliness, even if it's not loneliness itself, because there is also isolation, and extreme isolation can have detrimental effects. The BBC has a fascinating article called How Extreme Isolation Warps Your Mind, and one thing it talks about is how when people are isolated for long periods of time without sunlight, their sense of time gets thrown way off. Now, to test this on a smaller scale, head to toggle.com/time-perception-game. And to play, click this button to start. Without a clock, guess when you believe a minute has passed by clicking again. Chances are you might not get 60 seconds on the dot, but you should be close. But this is you now, not having been isolated or hidden from daylight. And in 1961, this French geologist descended a little over 905 meters into a cave where he lived for 2 months, cut off from everyone and sunlight. While conducting tests, it was discovered that he took 5 minutes to count what he thought was only 2 minutes. That's quite a discrepancy there. But just like that French geologist, many other people choose solitude, and for that reason, loneliness is sometimes replaced with enlightenment and understanding. But not everyone is lucky enough to choose, and some are even forced into solitude for years on end in solitary confinement. Many people report horror stories while in solitary confinement, and a particularly haunting one comes from Anthony Graves. He was a wrongfully convicted man for 18 years, and he spent 16 of those years in solitary confinement in an 8-foot by 12-foot cell. In this 360 YouTube video, he gives a very disturbing account of his time in isolation, and you can look around and see the conditions he lived in. If you're thinking there's not much to look at, well, that's pretty much the point, but you're able to click out. However, he wasn't. And being kept in solitary confinement can cause a lot of horrifying effects. One highly reported one is hallucinations, both visual and auditory. People have reported seeing flashes of light out of the corner of their eyes. One woman even reported hearing screaming, only to realize it was actually her own. If you're interested to experience what auditory hallucinations are like, grab some headphones and play this video. It's pretty eerie, just to warn you. And to see someone else deal with isolation, Michael Stevens, yes, that very same Michael Stevens from All Your Dreams and Fantasies, put himself in a room alone for 3 days for an episode of Mindfield. And I'll link to that episode in the description below, but it's very interesting to see how he acted in that room alone and how his brain functioned in cognitive tests after. Also, speaking of Michael and Mindfield, season 3 of Mindfield just came out on Vsauce 1, and I love it so far, and I'm so proud of my boy Michael. What? There will be a link to that in the description, as well as a link to it right here. Michael was also able to get YouTube to make that episode free, and I would highly recommend watching it. It has monkeys, Japan, and an epic battle between Michael and a chimp. Who will win? Leave a comment below saying that. Anyway, to wrap all this up, yes, isolation can cause a lot of devastation and loneliness, but it doesn't have to. Some people purposely cut off from society and go backpacking in the woods for months just to find a sense of inner peace and connection with nature. So with that, I'm gonna go prance into the woods until the next dawn. That's actually a lie because Hannah's gonna keep me in this room forever. But you know what? That's fine because I get to see you every now and then. Even though right after this, right when Hannah hits the record button to stop recording, she's probably gonna throw a bucket of ice water on me. Not for like a challenge video, just because she's cruel and unusual. And as always, help. Thanks for watching. Thanks for watching.